Our daughter was diagnosed with autism around the age of 3, suspected from about the age of 1.5 years. I remember when ABA was first mentioned to me by family members, I didn't know an awful lot about it. I'd only heard all the negative myths about it from the schools I worked in. And I suppose I kept putting my hand up saying, no, I'm not, don't want to go near that. I've heard nothing but negative things about it. So eventually I gave in, decided, look, sure, I'll meet these people in a way and see what they have to offer. And I suppose from a mother's point of view, I can safely say it was one of the best things I ever did. I don't know where Kira would be if it wasn't for ABA. I don't know why there's still the myths that there is about ABA, because Kira has had to learn every single thing, whether it's academic ability or whether it's life skills or the simplest thing from sitting down in a seat to going to the toilet to going out in a crowd, has all come from ABA. And to think that that ABA might not be given to parents or provided to parents or available in this country would just shatter me, because without it, I don't know where Kira would be. Kira is able to function in mainstream school using the ABA program. She's able to take part in plays, assemblies. She's come on leaps and bounds with her number work, her reading, etc. And none of it would have happened without ABA. The girls that have come down, they've come down regularly, they've built up relationships with Kira. They don't just deliver the ABA programme, they're very supportive to the families, they're very supportive to Kira. This myth of ABA punishing children and making children do things that they don't want to do is just, quite frankly, absolute rubbish. Kira has to be highly motivated, and can lack a lot of motivation, and ABA definitely encourages her along those lines. She would safely sit back.